Hello there, I'm Tim and he's John, and this is How to Murder Space, an instructional set of videos on how not to play space engineers.
I've had a little think.
Yeah, you've had a think. And well, you should. You have to go away and think about what you did last time. My God.
I know this is a controversial idea.
Yeah.
It may have been my fault.
I'm saying nothing. Just going to bask in this rare moment. So we decided that one single small thruster is not enough to control a large spaceship that's spinning out of control. So you've had looks like you've had a bit of a redesign here on the tug.
So we've now got three engines pointing all ways, and I've put on four reactors.
I really still don't think this is going to do it. Remember, a large thruster on a small... a large thruster... I did some reading, and the large thruster is equivalent to 12 small thrusters.
Yeah.
For both sizes, large and small grids. There you go, you're off. Right, I've got to follow this. This is going to be really important.
We need to do an experiment.
We're doing some science, aren't we? Yeah, okay, here we go.
I need you to get into the control panel for our large ship.
It's going to hurt, isn't it?
Okay, you'll be sitting there.
Right, here we go. That should be Bruce Willis today. Right, there we go. Right, so I am now at the helm of the SS, whatchamacallit.
Okay.
Currently a two-stage construction factory train ship.
What I need you to do is turn off the reactor.
Turn off the reactor, are you sure?
No, but do it anyway.
You haven't installed the thing where we have to both turn the keys at once, I see. There we go, reactor off. Oh, God, everything's lit up red.
Okay. Apparently
we're missing about 15 kilowatts of power. Okay, so we're just in inert piece of space junk at the moment. No damping, nothing. Do you need power to turn the merge blocks off, do you think?
It's now saying someone else is using this ship and I can't undock.
Do you want me to undock it?
No, I want you to jump out of that...
Okay, I'm now away and out. Okay, so you're moving the whole thing. How's your power loading?
26%. Okay, I have actually got control now.
Yeah, I think when it comes to feet and connectors, whereabouts on the thing you land is important. I think because you're on the centre line, you've not got a massive spin going on all of a sudden. Do you find it's rolling slightly as you move?
Yeah,
that's because you're not precisely on the centre line by the looks of it. You're about about half a metre to the left. I wouldn't suggest unclamping or anything. In fact, do not unclamp until everything's come to complete rest, because that's what's going to go wrong, I reckon.
Yeah, we're not coming to complete rest, and I think it's speeding up.
Really? Ow. All the engines on this back end are cold. There's nothing happening here, no jets.
Yeah, it's my engines doing it.
Why are they speeding you up?
Yeah, okay, I'm going to undock. Are you right next to the controls?
Is this the bit where I get my head cut off by a space thing? I'm next to the controls. I can jump in immediately, yep.
Yeah, have a go at that.
All right, I'm on board.
Okay, now turn...
Oh, now it's lifting up.
Yeah, it is. Turn the reactor back on.
Oh, it just flashed up suit failure imminent. Oh, I think that's because there's a fraction of a second before it realises there's power to give my suit. Yes, I think we've come to a complete stop now. Power usage is blipping around, but I think that's just damping going on. Can't see the jets at the back flaring, so...
I can't.
I think we've come to a stop, yeah.
Yeah, only I'm now completely stuck on and I can't come off.
How do you... Is this a faction thing? Does everything belong to the faction?
Oh, could be.
Ooh, would that be a problem? That'd be part of why the tug wouldn't work if some of the jets belonged to me. Some crazy like that. We need to make sure everything belongs to... Ooh, sorry, that was me. Everything needs to belong to... Owner Nobody, apparently. Large Ship 6801, which is a snappy name, I have to say. Transfer to me, Senyek.
Make sure it's shared with faction.
So, transfer to me. You sure you want to change onto me? Yes. And share with my faction. Oh, that was just Control Station 5. Oh, God. Right, so the whole... Control A selects everything, that's good. Owner transfer to me. Yes. Share with my faction. Me share. Yes, okay, so I own everything now, including... Because while it's docked, I imagine your little ship is probably a part of the ship 6801.
I was being silly. I am on it now.
Oh, you forgot. You left the handbrake on, did you?
I left the handbrake I put too many engines on this thing.
Is it quite fast? That was my other thing. See, the tug design I had in mind when I was thinking about it at work today would have had had at least six large thrusters to do the actual hauling, but then you turn those off when you're doing the fine manoeuvring and you'd have six small thrusters, like a tiny, normal little ship, and you use that for just moving about without power. It's like trucks, isn't it? They go mental if they don't have a trailer on the back. They're much, much faster. That's why people do truck racing and things. It's all to do with, like, physics and forces and science.
I was watching truck racing.
Imagine it's a monster truck in with no like friction or something. I don't know. Anyway, right, so that gives us hope. We got some. So your current revised tug design is capable of shifting that entire docked section. Very although slowly. Quite slowly, and it goes out of control quite easily. But that's progress, I think. To be honest.
Yep.
Right, what's next? Let's do some stuff that's successful.
What's
next? What are you doing there? Oh, you're putting large thrusters on it. Yeah, see?
Yes, right. What's next is you're getting your construction ship.
Okay.
I want you to finish all these merge blocks with some priority.
Yes, because regular viewers will remember that was basically the only thing that stopped us losing the entire spaceship into light forever. Okay. This is not a precision tool that I was hoping for, but dealing with large blocks is a lot easier because that's sort of what it was designed for.
Have you considered adding more engines? Because it worked for me.
You can't solve every problem by adding more engines. What am I saying? Right. Steady does it. Is that crosshair... That crosshair's the cockpit. Not a particular part of the ship, isn't it?
Something like that.
Yeah, okay, that's not much help either. Good. There we go, green light's coming on over here. And it stopped, I've run out of something. I ran out of. I have to get out and have a look, it doesn't tell you that. Yeah, could do with like a screen in the cockpit or something. No, that's done. Why's that not gone green? Interesting. Oh, it's complete, it's just not on. I think you've not got the control grouping.
Oh, no, it's right fine. It. We'll just need to undock it and put it back on again and see what happens.
Okay. All right. Back to work. So that's the other thing. The lack of a hissing sound from the front of the spaceship doesn't tell me if it's either run out of components or it's finished its work. All right, the connector as well. So it can pass power through the merge blocks, can it? As well as access to component controls.
Yeah.
Okay, so but to pass actual physical cargo, you need the yellow round connectors on the top. Okay, so far so good. It's not vanished into space, let's put it that way.
Well, not yet this episode.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to this week's disaster.
I wonder what we can do this week to completely screw stuff up.
I think we're still in the early design disasters phase, more than any kind of massive navigational problems phase. Oh, hopefully I'm not pushing this thing too far. Oh, it's still got an active... Oh, did we turn the reactor back on?
I don't know, did you?
It was me, wasn't it? Yeah, we did. The engines are there. Okay,
That's fine.
No, this whole thing's damping correctly, so me nudging it's not going to send it into the middle of next week. Right. So that means we'll need the merge blocks on the other end sorted out as well. That way we can use this to catch the next thing that goes mad. Or are we going to make me reverse into the next one? Do you know you've got the cargo connector on the far end of this section on the other end? Is that meant to happen?
Yes.
So you weren't not running top to top?
What?
Nothing? Oh, no, it's me. Sorry, I've gone upside down.
You're just completely lost.
I've gotten space vertigo sickness. What weighs up? What is up? Oh God, what's happened now? Is that this week's disaster? Wow, something just went past really fast. Was that you? It's like a streak. I didn't know we had meteors turned on. Astute viewers will notice we haven't been bombarded by meteors yet. It's because I tried that once on a single player game and it was terrifying, so we turned those off.
That's terrifying.
We stop building drag racers and finish that tug. You see, the clever tug design I was thinking of in my imaginary mind was it had control groupings to turn the large thrusters on and off as needed. I don't know if yours has a similar idea. That way you can not disappear into the next galaxy every time you push W.
What you're doing there is not explaining why you don't sometimes need to not go fast.
I suppose if you're chasing an outer control ship module, yeah. Wow, look at that crater in the deck there. I'm going to leave that. I think that tells a story there.
That one there?
The vast one next to the...
Yeah, that's actually been there for a little while. That was when I docked it in the first place.
So, yeah, as we've seen before, if it's got active ones of these on each end of this each section, then if it does go mental and out of control, then we're at least able to capture it. Mind you, your tug ought to do it as well. It seems to be powerful enough, although there does seem to be some question about whereabouts you have to connect to be able to control stuff. Still don't quite understand how the centre of gravities and things work in this game. Not the way you'd think, mostly. Okay, welding. Because these cargo connectors exert a fair bit of force as well if they're powered, so they can also be used to grab errant spaceships.
Merge modules are actually very strong.
The merge modules, yeah. Just seeing what they did with how they worked with the one we captured. Very powerful. It's like almost utterly immune to any kind of sort of shearing forces or whatever. Absolutely the right sort of thing to be using for this, I think.
Hello.
Well, how much stuff did you put in this ship?
Quite a lot.
Haven't run out of materials yet.
Hello. If you turn to your right a bit.
Yeah.
You see two reactors there.
Oh, you're so lazy. Come here. Hold still. Try and tattoo you as well. Do you want a spread eagle holding a skull?
Definitely.
With a snake coming out of his eye. No, I've missed one. I think you might be missing a reactor component. I don't carry those. Yeah, the one in the middle on the second row's got an open hatch. And plus you're going to have to fuel all those as well. But yeah. You're welcome.
Yeah.
Don't mind me, I'm just doing the hard work around it.
I had to run off and get some oxygen.
Did you forget to give it an oxygen tank? I'm lovely and toasty in here. It's got a little pine tree air freshener and everything. Right. Okay, let's just back off and go for a bit of a quick spacewalk. Just have a look at those. See if they're... I think they're done if they've got the white light on the centre. Yeah, that's looking good. I do say so myself. Some fine welding there. Okay. Oh, there's a set on the other end of this piece, isn't there? Yep, okay, let's go and get that.
There's a set on every end.
I'm getting quite attached to my spaceship.
Wouldn't suppose you.
There's no set on the far end of that wide one. Is that all going to be windows or something?
That's the bridge.
Yeah, that's the front one. Right.
That's where we see out.
I don't want to see out. Can we just wall up the bridge? I mean, who has windows on a spaceship anyway? You've got LCD cameras and things.
Platform's all the way back over here.
Having adventures. Let's have a quick look at the inventory. Yeah. Mostly it's going to be steel plates and construction components, but it looks like we've still got loads. So, right, crack on. Well, the assembler fairies have been really busy this week. Okay, that should be that one done as well. Oh no, my OCD can't hack it. I'm gonna repair the platform. Bloody great crater in it. I mean, I know the plan's to dismantle it. There we go, look at that. Pop, 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 pop. Then we're going to dismantle it and take it with us, but no excuse for sloppiness.
Oh well, 3 feet to that. Yes, you need to be careful with this ship.
Which ship? Oh god, have you built some kind of crazily out of control? Wow, there you go. I mean, yeah. wow. wow. You're gone, it's like a dot. Like, power to weight ratio is the thing here. Look at that. Happy trails. Let's get to right. Wow, you literally are a pixel now. I think that's you. Here's a suggestion. Put an antenna on that thing, for God's sake. If you die in the cockpit with the dampeners off, that is just gone. We're never seeing it again.
Yeah, I'm not turning the dampeners off. I'm going to have it just explore.
Right, okay. Well, you have fun while I do lots of heavy lifting and welding and things. Right, I've done all your connectors. What do you want next? Shall I go and complete the one that's attached to the other bit? All right, let's go and do that. What's that then? That looks like one of those refineries on there.
Yeah, don't worry about the refineries yet. Get all of the structural in.
Okay. It's assuming my welding's that precise.
I really should have put an ore scanner on this, shouldn't I?
are you seeking out new life and things?
Oh, and civilizations.
Mm-hmm. Presumably for their salvageable parts. See, this is why I built it so long and pointy, with the unnecessary extra pointy outy bits. It's so that we can fit into angles like that. It's the AOE-ness of it. It does 2 blocks deep, but depending on the angle you're pointing, you can catch many more than that in one go. And you just sit there until the hissing noise stops, and that means it's finished building the things it's building, or it's run out of components. We should have... This would have taken a very long time indeed to do by hand. Your welding torch.
Yeah, that's why we desperately need a bigger one of those.
Bigger than this?
Yes, 3D printer.
You show me the YouTube of that. It was astonishingly inventive. I'll have to put a link or something somewhere, but amazing. Literally mass production of spaceships automatically. Quite a feat. Okay, so the idea is that we're going to have like a central access corridor down the middle of the whole thing, and presumably that's going to be pressurised, is it?
No.
Okay.
Because of limitations.
Oxygen is overrated. Particularly inside the larger structures. Oh yeah, it's useful to have oxygenated cockpits for utility ships and things, and available supplies for restoring your suit, but... Just running around with the helmet off, that's just extravagant and decadent. Might as well be playing medieval engineers. Right. That's looking good. Nice smooth finish. Alright, let's do the... Right, let's have a go at the conveyor tube. That's going to consume quite a lot of components. Let's see if we can get it done. What should be done as possible?
Bad news.
Oh, you can't find your way back, can you? Because you've gone beyond 20k.
No, I'm at 18k. I was following a couple of blue pixels on an asteroid.
Blue pixels? Ooh, interesting. Nothing in nature is blue, apart from the sky and many flowers and the sea. Certain sorts of fish. But apart from all that... So you found something man-made out there, you reckon?
Yeah.
Oh, no, it's building the refineries as well. Oh, well.
That's fine.
The refineries are actually quite easy, because that's what you need to make everything else, but they can use a lot of steel plates. So that's what I'm going to be running low on. 3,000 to go. Yeah, okay.
Okay, I'm running back to base now, because got our first place to explore.
Oh, wow. What are we going to explore it with? Apart from your space Vespa there.
We'll take the entire...
Okay. I suppose once we get there, we'll be able to refine the bejesus out of whatever it is. Okay. Conveyor block. Oh. This is taking a long time to weld. It must be something pretty big.
Refinery.
I think it might be doing a refinery, yeah. Oh, it's stopped. I think I'm out of something. What am I out of?
Steel plates for a refinery.
No, small steel tubes. Lots of those needed for all of this conveyor stuff. Yeah, if you're near the... Are you over at the base?
No. That's 12 kilometres, not as close.
Oh, and there's no antenna on the base either, so I can't control it from here. Oh, well. Antennas for... Space stations are really big, awkward structures to build. And if we're just going to pack the whole thing up and turn it into a spaceship anyway, it's probably not worth it. But I'll carry on welding some of the other bits. But yeah, small steel tubes in the thousands, probably. That's what we're going to be needing next. I've been doing welding. It's coming along.
Yeah. Great. I should probably say I crashed in case anyone...
I've been rambling like, you know, crazy for like...
Yeah. I didn't want to tell you that your voice gets recorded at my end.
Okay, good. It'll be some fun editing then.
Yeah. Yeah, so, yes, I crashed. I'm in the middle of space. I've lost a ship, no beacon on it, but I sort of know where it is. So if anyone actually had me losing yet another ship on the list of things that I would do wrong this episode, they could drink hell.
Oh, that's looking quite... I don't know. Well, the ship's looking quite cool as it is, actually, the big ship. It's got that sort of big super space destroyer type look to it. Oh, I wonder if we want to clad it or not. I suppose we ought to, because we don't want the vulnerables on the outside, like the refinery.
We are going to have to consider combat.
It's going to need armour, isn't it? Yeah.
People are going to attack us.
It's quite impressive, though. It's what we got so far.
You wait till we put the upgrades onto the edges.
Oh, yeah. Lots to go. It's just the... It's just the spine we're building now. Okay.
I like the loading screens.
That's good, because you're seeing them a lot. Okay. No, I haven't crashed out once. At all, when I've been playing this so far, so I'm not quite sure.
Crashes my graphics driver.
Oh, right. NVIDIA, is it? Usual latest in GeForce Experience thing, whatever. Yeah. Have you got a particularly new swanky card? Yeah. I haven't. I think we're both.
Also, it is 300 degrees in this room, so it could be overheating.
Yeah, yeah.
As you know, these GPU temperatures are quite stable.
All right, well, at the moment I'm waiting on a big batch of small steel tubes, because I think that's what the remaining bits and pieces on the megaship require. And then, so what have you got for assemblers? Have you got any of that on any of these sections?
Yep, the next section along.
Ah, okay. Oh, wow, the feet are going twitchy, twitchy, twitchy again. That's really unsettling, seeing something that big vibrating so fast.
Uh-oh. Mm.
I think they're right for the moment, just don't go near them. They'll start killing you again. Right. There we go. I think we've got enough tubes for the moment. There's the oxygen. Oh yeah, so it refilled the oxygen tank. That's good. Put the 8-track on. Off we go. So turn that off and away. Okay. So yeah, let's just get the refineries done. Then we can. Probably have to run round and inspect on foot the rest of it. Make sure we've got all the innards. No! Oh wow, so what was that? What's that missing then? That's not small steel tubes, is it? Yeah. You need motors. Oh, and computers. It's not done the computers either. Motors and computers, right?
Sounds about
right.
There
we go.
So I reckon that's my ship.
Oh, shit. That's right, the rescue mission. Have you found it yet? It was quite small. It looked like a white pixel.
I'm chasing down a pixel at the moment.
Try background parallax. It's a trick I learnt in Elite Dangerous. If you go sideways at like 75 times the speed of light, you'll see that your spaceship will move across the background.
Am I good? I found that instantly.
Oh, well done. You obviously have an affinity for the tug.
I was doing that, looking at it at a slight angle to see what happens.
Could you add that to the spawn list? The respawn list? Do you need a medical thingy or something, or a cryopod on board?
Something.
Yeah, because I noticed that when you die, and I seem to die every time I use the cryopod, not that I'm, you know, suspicious of the only other crew member.
The problem is, you die every time there's an upgrade to the server, and the server upgrades every week.
Oh, I see. Well, I don't know why we bothered building the cryopod then. It
seemed like a good idea.
It's going to keep murdering us. Also, that we can retain our personal inventories, which, like, you know, is a welding torch. Okay. Yep, so otherwise steel tubes anyway. Production, change all that. Why can't I product? I'll have to get out. I connected. Yes. Oh. Right. I guess I just need to retask some of the factories.
Really hard.
Get rid of all that. Motors. Got 100 of those. And what's the other thing we needed? Computers. A couple hundred of those. Missing items. Oh, hello.
Uh-oh,
we
gold, isn't it?
Gold, yes. We are completely out of gold. There we go, new bottleneck. Looks like you got a mission, mining captain.
How are we doing for the rest of this stuff apart from...
No, I've just set a massive stack of motors going. Let's see, make sure, try and see what those all need. Cobalt, nickel and iron. Entryways, all the stuff. Assembler's pulling them all in. It's all in the container, isn't it? Cobalt loads, iron loads, nickel loads. Yeah, we're okay for motors. Silicon's all right. Platinum. Oh, hang on. Platinum. Yeah, platinum. We've only got 50 kilograms of it, but it uses 0.01 grams or something a go, doesn't it? So I think we're okay for that.
That's loads of platinum.
That's actually loads, isn't it? Magnesium we've got almost none of, but then I don't think we really need any of that until we start building guns and things. So, yes, we just need gold. Gold! And silver as well. We're out of silver, incidentally. We've got a small stack of silver in one of the assemblers, but I think if we start building reactor components in any quantity, I think we're going to be in trouble. So, gold first, silver second.
Okay.
And then I shall carry on chucking the motors on, at least. So, what's the cargo hold for the welding ship, there it is. Chuck those in there. The rest of that. Wow, did it really have no gold at all? Yeah, those computers are not happening at all. So yeah, we're completely out of gold at the moment, so make that the priority. What does that do? Enable or disable cooperative mode. Enable or disable repeat mode. So presumably repeat mode is just build infinitely until you run out.
I think so.
And cooperative mode? Does that mean
it's,
one of them,
it shares...
Yeah, they both work on the same item, sharing their power and stuff. Yeah. Interesting. All right, we can get the motors put on board anyway. Oh, hello. Six. Oh. Right, so one of your many deaths left a welding torch on the deck, and I don't like clutter and mess, so I picked it up and I disassembled it, and it gave us enough gold to make six computers. So I have a plan B if you can't find any gold. But you're not going to like it.
That's a not very good plan.
It does involve killing you over and over and over and then stealing your tools.
For the record, we're up to 20,000 of gold already.
Oh, it looks like you live then. I don't need to kill you for your welding torch. Right, disconnect, and off we go. So I've got enough motors to get the conveyor tubes finished, I think. Up we go. Power usage overload. Need another reactor on here, maybe. That hissing and that clank. Progress. More progress.
All things considered, I think I like my mining ship the most.
Yeah, your tug's been a bit willful. Not saying it's directly the cause of your death, but right. Green lights all along the spine. Excellent. Conveyors all up. I think one of the refineries is finished as well. Just try and ferry some... Yeah, come over and dock on here when you come back with the gold. Drop some in, see if it works. We haven't got any assemblies, though, have we? Hey, we could dock the whole cluster onto the platform. I don't even rate my flying that well. It's going to pile straight through it all, aren't we? Okay. Yeah, I think we're just pretty much waiting on the... on the computers now. Gold seems to refine quite quickly though, so we should be in good shape soon. And the computers themselves manufacture quite quickly. Right, so pop out and have a little wander around, fly around with the welding torch, see what's left. So, yeah. Central corridor. Ah! Oh, no gravity! Right. Oh, hang on, I've missed an entire... Oh dear. Can't reach far enough in to get these. That might need doing by hand. Okay, four refineries. They all just need computers.
Oh, excellent.
I think. Yeah, we need about 60 computers over here, and then all the refineries are up and ready. That's going to tax whatever reactor you've got a fair bit, I imagine. So look, that's all coming off the one at the back here, isn't it?
Yeah.
Which has got 0.58 of fuel in there. That needs to bring some uranium over at some point if you can. Considering, oh, I can do that. Hang on, my welding ship's got like 150 units in. Something crazy insane like that.
Dare we try bringing over the next module?
Oh, where did 150 go then? That was on something else that was docked to it all, was it?
Probably the...
the miner. I don't know. Anyway, need more uranium on the main ship before we try anything crazy. And the computers for the refineries. I'll see if I can reach that inside set of blocks.
How many computers do you
need? About 60 or so. That's the only thing missing from these refineries. Ah, good design there. You've left the sockets on the facing upwards so that we can fit the production modules and things on if we need.
Stop moving.
Okay. I see you. Has the camera, has the little light on the camera gone green?
Red at the moment.
Ah, I thought it went green if someone was looking through it. Right. That's this. One over here. Right, there we go. Four refineries ready to go. I can't reach the internal Yeah, you're going to have to go in there and do that by hand, I think. That row of blocks beneath the conveyor. Don't seem to get far enough into it. It's alright, grab a stack of steel plates and just run along there with a hand torch. I'll do it myself. Do you want to bring another module over, you're saying?
Yeah.
Oh, it turns not. It turns pretty quickly. How many gyros you got on there? So just the one.
It's not the speediest.
No, but it turns well enough. I thought it was going to just, you know, be really bad at that. Right. So I guess you want to pick up the assembly section next, yeah?
Yeah. There's only one slight problem.
Is the foot freaking out?
No, it's backwards.
Are the assemblers backwards or you're backwards? Wait, well, you got the tug if you want to put the refinery on behind you or something.
Actually, no, I can do this.
Right. This is really brilliant. I'm standing by with the repair ship.
Biggest problem.
Mm-hmm. Oh, look at that thing dancing through the air like a gazelle. Right. You can't see what you're doing at all, can you?
I can't see what I'm doing, and I've got the horrible feeling that after I dock, you may have to destroy that the landing foot very quickly.
I'm not going near that landing foot.
Somebody's got to, and...
Oh, God, right, hold on then. Right, slow. Right, so down. Slow, down. Down a bit. Down a bit. Okay, stop. Just come to a full stop. Oh, I'm going to get out and spacesuit this, aren't I? Here we go.
Yep.
Tell Daphne I love her. Alright, so.
Okay. There. Don't cut it yet.
No. I'm still guiding you in yet. Right, forwards.
Full speed.
1/4 impulse.
Full speed ahead.
You overestimate the robustness of these ships. Keep going forwards, up a little, spacebar. Up. Slow forwards, back. That's it, right. Good, stop. Right, up a bit. And stop. Right, now slowly forwards and you should dock. Up a bit.
That'd be fine.
I'm seeing yellows across the board. Are you not gone? I don't know, what do you do? Press P or something?
No, it'll go green automatically.
No, right, don't do it. Leave it yellow for now. I'll cut the foot.
I can't.
Oh?
No, we want it to go green.
Yeah?
Has it gone green?
It's still yellow.
On both sides?
Well, this side anyway. Yeah, it's all yellow. You might need to...
Is it wobbling around?
A little, yeah. Right, hang on, stop. Right, rotate nose up a little and backwards somewhat. And then down with C. Slide down. Strafe down, that's it. Strafe down, nose up. Right, slowly forwards. There we go. Oh, that's okay. Yeah, that's quite picky, isn't it? Got to be right on the right angle. Right, okay, I'm cutting the foot. Actually, it's gone yellow. You should just be able to lift off.
I have, yes.
Yeah. Oh, did you turn the foot off from controls?
Yeah.
Oh, excellent.
I get controls.
That's how it should work. Fantastic.
Yeah.
God, look at that thing. It's about a kilometre long now, is it? Right, I'm cutting the foot away. Here we go. Actually, no, I need to... the foot's got to have better... Did you build the foot? I think I may have built the foot accidentally when I was fixing the... I need to use the grinder! Here comes the grinder ship. The red end. What's the grinder? Grinder. Toggle lock on off. It's off at the moment. Right, here we go. Die, foot! See? It's yin and yang, this spaceship. What I give, I can take away!
Please just take out the foot.
Yeah, and you wanted a wall of grinders. See, this is why we only have one grinder on the spaceship.
Oh, precision, I want the wall of demolition. Grinders for...
We can build a grinder wall ship later for hilarious offensive purposes, but for precision work... Here we go. Grinding. And gone. Right, now turn it off immediately. So I don't graze it against the rest of the ship.
Okay.
There we go.
We've got a ship a bit more assembled, and we've done enough for this episode.
Right. Join us next time as we build a bridge to another asteroid that we can run along the middle of with rockets on it.
See you next time.
Bye.